Nearly three women are murdered every day in the U.S. by current or former romantic partners. And in St. Paul, police are trying to change those numbers.
Police there say the last two homicides were linked to domestic abuse. But there is an effort in place looking to stop that cycle of abuse. Adrian?
Jana, the program is called a Blueprint for Safety, and now it's gaining national attention. St. Paul police and an abuse survivor will travel to Ireland to talk about the project. But first, that survivor is sharing her story with us. And I want to warn you, some of the images are hard to view.
It's hard to reach out for help, especially when you feel like you have nothing left. You're so broken and you don't really feel like you have any self-worth.
These photos are reminders of what Christy James survived.
He started off small, like, I guess, you know, pushing and shoving, name calling.
She says over a two-year period, her boyfriend's abuse led to these bloody wounds and hospital visits.
It got worse as he got more comfortable and I got more scared. It progressed to me being locked in a room, him pushing more aggressively, choking, slaps.
This mother of two escaped, but other stories have different endings. In St. Paul, police there say the latest two homicides were victims of domestic violence.
That's terrifying and sad. I definitely could have been in that situation if I hadn't reached out for help.
Help for James was thanks to a partnership between St. Paul Police and the St. Paul Intervention Project. Senior Commander Axel Henry helped launch the program.
I don't think there's an officer that's not walked out of a domestic call and looked at their partner and said, you know, that person's going to kill the other person someday, or he's going to kill her someday.
The program is called a Blueprint for Safety. It is an effort to connect victims of domestic abuse with the right services at the right time so they can break the cycle of abuse.
We've created a process and a language by which we can take the kind of information that were gut feelings or senses, and we can actually drill down into those areas through the lethality assessments and other processes so that we're basically able to note those things in a way in a police report that not only is understood by other police officers and investigators, but later on down the chain.
Members of law enforcement in Ireland are considering adopting a similar program. This team will travel to Ireland this week.
In Ireland, we're going to be introducing and talking about the Blueprint for Safety. It's a framework for the criminal justice system's response from 911 all the way to the bench of how a victim should be treated by our justice system.
James will share her story too.
I would like just for anybody listening to know that if you, you know, pick up the phone, the help is there.
The help is there, and this program encourages police to do the basics, take more photos at the scene, ask more questions, write more reports. And St. Paul police say they have had fewer repeat calls for service from people involved in domestic assaults. And this is a program that has been around for 12 years. Okay. This group travels to Ireland on Friday. They will be there for 7 days.
And since it's been around for 12 years, they already have those calls in the system so they know where they're going, kind of thing?
Yeah. Exactly. Thank you,
Adrian. Whatever helps and whatever stops it. Thanks, Adrian.